This is Tom Lusher at Fog Lounge in Windsor, Ontario, and you're watching Today's Windsor.
You've been thinking about it. Blue Water Surgical Center, bluewatersurgery.com.
Howdy, y'all.
I can't believe you said that.
There's some good eats.
This is unbelievable. Biscuits and gravy is our location, and you know what?
That's why I said it kind of funny. I know it's a bad Southern accent, but I'm trying.
That was supposed to be Southern?
I'm trying.
Well, I gotta tell you, you're gonna chat with Steve while I consume some of the unbelievable stuff that they have here. Of course, the name is Biscuits and Gravy, so of course they serve biscuits and gravy, but get a load of this. Fried green tomatoes, and if you haven't had them, I don't know what you're waiting for. We've got catfish as well, plus on top of it, chicken wings, and these. I am telling you, I was somebody who did not like sweet potatoes at all. Sweet potato fries are phenomenal. And since, you know, I don't want to be rude and talk with food in my mouth, you guys talk and I'm just gonna eat.
We finally got her to be quiet. That's nice.
There we go.
Steve's the guy who's responsible for all this. Tell me how biscuits and gravy came about. And am I correct, that's what you're focusing on, is the traditional Southern comfort food?
Absolutely. The way it came about was in 2000, me and a friend, we did a 3-week trip to Mardi Gras, which culminated in Mardi Gras. And we just did this long trip. We had friends to visit and family to visit. And then what we promised each other, we said, while we're driving down, no fast food joints, no chain restaurants.
Get a flavor of the
absolutely.
Culture.
Let's find all the little mom and pop joints, all those great little places.
What a great trip!
Oh, absolutely. we saw some great food. You know, we saw some great places. Ate great food. We ate not great food, but it was a great cross section of society and of the culinary world. Came back, and I said to myself, "Oh, I remember that dish on." How do I make it? And, you know, just go back and trying my own, finding recipes wherever I can, mixing and matching, trying different things. And it was basically a nine-year love and a nine-year process. And I got a chance to open a restaurant, and I said, well, what am I going to do? And it was obvious. It was just, got to do it.
So and you put some serious research and work into this, then.
A lot of food, yes. And it, wow. I think it shows along my waistline, too, unfortunately. But
it shows on the dish, that's for sure. This is, get out.
Ooh.
She's vicious.
Don't touch my food.
Oh, that's good to hear anyways.
Yeah, oh no, it is fantastic stuff. And what I find interesting is not only do you make this, mm-hmm. You can tell it's a passion of yours just because you seem to know the origin and the history of these dishes and where they come from.
Absolutely. I mean, I'm a foodie at heart, that would probably be the best way to put it. No matter what type of dish it is, I always like finding out the reasons why a dish is called a certain way or where it's come from or what area of the region. And each region has its own different version of the dish sometimes. And so trying different, maybe a North Carolina version compared to a Georgia version or a New Orleans version versus maybe someplace else, Memphis, you know. And you just find all those different styles and you find out how everybody does it. And then somewhere in the middle, you'll find something that's really good and you just try it yourself. Wow.
And you can get it all right here at Biscuits and Gravy, which is on Pulitzer, just a little bit south of University. You've got to stop by. Now, tell me a little bit. You were making a dish earlier. I saw the Carpetbagger Steak. What is it exactly?
Well, we're doing a special this week. It's called the Carpetbagger Steak. And what? It's a southern dish basically based on the fact that after the Civil War, a lot of Northerners with a lot of money came down trying to reap the benefits of the fact that the Northern side won the Civil War. And Southerners basically called them carpetbaggers because they would bring down their luggage would be this huge old carpet bag that would you carry all their stuff in. And so what they do is they just come down and they decide to make a dish that would appease the Northern palate. And so what we do is fried oysters and blue cheese. And what we do is we stuff it inside an actual steak and we cook your steak to order like that. So it's this huge steak, nice and juicy inside. And once you cut into it, you get that nice fried oyster, blue cheese, excellent dish.
Oh, how decadent is that? That's beautiful stuff. And when are you open?
We're open 5 days, or sorry, 7 days a week. 9 to 2 every day for breakfast and lunch. And then 5 days for dinner between Tuesday and Saturday, 5 to 9:30 or 5 to 10, depending on the day.
Well, it is a fantastic spot. Everybody here is getting into it. Look at Hootie's pretty much demoed that dish. And our...
Did you want some?
Our sound technician, Erica, let me tell you, she fits in here like you would not believe. This girl, she's made for this place. Got to get her to work a little harder there. Though it's a great spot, and congratulations.
Well, thank you very much.
Steven,
thank you very much.
We'll be back again for sure. You should be too. Y'all come back now. Here, better?
That's so good.